So Huion sent me their Canvas 13 Gen 3 just to see how well it holds up for 3D artists, and more precisely for sculpting and texturing workflows. So specifically, I'm going to be testing this tablet by sculpting Warwick from Arcane inside ZBrush. That, by the way, you can check the full timelapse in this other video just here. So let's see if this budget-friendly tablet can handle the pressure, like quite literally. But before we start, don't forget to like and subscribe so I can produce more videos like this in the future. All right, let's jump in. So let's start with the basics first. The Huion Kamvas 13 Gen 3 is lightweight, it's portable, and it's a nice improvement over its predecessor. It features a 13.3-inch screen with a full HD resolution, which is vibrant and crisp for a tablet of this size. Also, it covers 99% of the sRGB and Rec. 709 standard color gamuts, which make it okay for workflows like texturing, for example. So out of the box, you'll find the tablet, a pen with a holder plus some extra nibs, a foldable stand, a 3-in-1 cable for connectivity, and a glove, which I actually didn't need thanks to the tablet matte texture, which I'm going to be talking about that later on. The installation and the calibration was pretty quick and painless, so I was ready to dive into the sculpting in no time. The 30-inch display adopts anti-glare canvas glass, which not only reduces reflections, but also adds paper-like texture. In fact, I just have here a main window, and as you can tell, you almost have no reflection. And during my sculpting process while I was doing Warwick, I noticed that I have no issues when it came to reflections or having the window open on the side. So when it comes to the sculpting, I really enjoy its texture, really. One of the major reasons, because I didn't need to use the glove, and normally for display tablets, you normally need the glove to be able to have a smooth transition while you are just moving around with the hand. And in this case, I noticed that I have no issues, and I was offering enough resistance against the hand while I was sculpting, so it really felt very natural in that sense. So this tablet also, let me just grab it here, it offers two dial controllers. All right, so you see the two dial controllers here, and it has also 5 express keys. Something that I really like is actually the way the radials were working, because it really feels enough resistance while you are just, you know, spinning those. And the buttons feel nice, but to be honest with you, as a 3D artist, I'm not a big fan of any side button. In fact, I rely way too much on shortcuts, really. So normally while I'm sculpting, I have my keyboard here. So I will have my left hand on the keyboard while my right hand will be on the pen, in this case here. So I don't really need that. And I wish on the future there would be tablets actually with no any side buttons. Nevertheless, on the other hand, I'm aware that mentioning that as a 3D artist, but the truth is that this can be very useful for digital painting. And also I know 3D animators use it a lot, because you can, you know, set up macros and this kind of stuff. But at the end of the day, as a 3D artist, I just don't feel any need of those. Yeah. The box came also with a foldable stand. It's sturdy, easy to adjust, and did the job just well through the whole entire sculpting process. So otherwise, it was actually pretty good. One of the things that I like the most, and I think that my favorite here actually was the pen. This pen is the new PenTech 4.0 technology, which is battery free. And something I really like is the fact that it comes with 3 buttons, and the way the buttons are set up, it makes for me total sense, because previously I was working with another tablet, and the 3 button setup, I didn't like it. You still have the 2 side buttons as usual as any other tablet like Wacom or Sense Labs, but this third button, in my opinion, makes total sense, and it was very easy to work with. And during the whole process, I was constantly playing with the side button. You just need to press here, and it was just working fine, and it was not literally, I was not moving too much the pen while pressing the button, so I really like that. On the other hand, this side button, one of the reasons why I was using it is because I wanted to test the radial menu that Huion allows you to have, which, even though it was kind of cool having a radial menu, which is final run is like 6 different shortcuts, it was pretty limited, because on top of that, it's only 6 shortcuts. You cannot rename them, and you cannot even use icons, like for example, in Auto Hotbar, which you can customize the whole experience, and you can make the whole, you know, macro functions just way easier. So even though it's kind of cool having the third button, I just felt like it was very limited. So now for the real test, sculpting Warwick from Arcane in ZBrush. This is where the toddler really shines in some areas, but also show its limitations. One specifically quite big on my opinion, so I'm going to be describing that later on. First, I want to talk about the matte surface. Made the experience feel very natural, almost like stretching on a paper, so it was very easy to sculpt on this tablet. However, the full HD resolution on a 13.3-inch screen felt limited during the whole sculpting process. On the bad side, I found myself struggling navigating inside ZBrush due to the full HD feature that it doesn't handle 4K resolution interface, which in my opinion is just not justified. So most of the menus during the whole sculpting process were hidden or occluded and was quite hard to find a good sculpting pace really. So eventually after a day and a half working on the display tablet, I decided to disconnect the HDMI cable and utilize the tablet also as a pen tablet. And that's something that I found quite fascinating because this tablet allows you to work not only as a display tablet, but also as a pen tablet. And I eventually, when it came to the sculpting, I decided to finalize the whole character using this as a pen tablet. So we're going to be talking now about the pros and cons so you can understand better what are my final conclusions on this tablet. First, it's quite affordable, so it's a great value for beginners or artists on a tight budget. It's also very portable, it's lightweight and easy to carry, ideal to work on the go. That's the best case scenario. Also, the display is quite vibrant. It covers the 99% of sRGB, which is great when it comes to texturing process. The pen performance was great, really. It was responsive, it was smooth, and also you have, again, the three buttons that you can customize. Also, something that I really liked was the paper-like texture and also the anti-glare canvas, so you don't have these problems when it comes to reflections. The foldable stand was actually good. It does the job pretty well, and it seems actually made with good materials. And finally, and it's worth mentioning, that it's easy to calibrate and to set up. And now when it comes to the cons, the thing that I didn't like the most definitely was the fact that it was not able to handle 4K resolution. Again, I cannot justify a 13-inch tablet unless it's touchscreen. And if you want to work in a more professional environment, I would recommend you to go for higher tablets that at least 15 inches plus, because 13 inches is not enough, really. Also, it has limited customization. The Radial menu only allows you 6 shortcuts, and renaming options are missing, which I feel like is a bit lame, because at the end of the day, you want to rename and ideally, you know, customize more the menus. So in that sense, I would recommend you to use softwares like AutoHotPy. Also, something I didn't like was the 3-in-1 cable. It requires HDMI and a USB-A port, which might not suit for all setups. Obviously, I don't like the fact that it's no touchscreen, and I only mention that because, in my opinion, the screen is small and it kind of resembles more to a tablet, like an iPad tablet, which I don't think is enough for like a professional environment. And then finally, the side buttons. While they're nice for some workflows, I believe as a 3D artist, I don't find any need for those. So again, I wish in the future we can have tablets without any of that. So who is the Huion Kamvas 13 Gen 3 really for? If you're a beginner or on a tight budget or need a portable tablet for working on the go, I think this is a fantastic option. The good display, the excellent pen, and also the foldable stand, it makes a great entry-level choice. However, for a more advanced 3D workflow like sculpting, I would recommend upgrading for a larger screen. Or for example, at least the Pro version, which is also higher resolution and can handle 4K. So that said, for texturing or general drawing, I think this tablet offers an excellent value for its price. If you have any question or want to critique my Warwick sculpt, I don't know, drop a comment below. And don't forget to like and subscribe for more 3D art tips and great reviews. So thanks for watching, and I catch you in the next video.